Hi girls, this is your science miss. I hope you all had gone through the unit 6 microorganisms which I sent on Monday. In this session we are going to highlight few important points in this microorganism topic. First, microorganism. Microorganisms are too small in size. They cannot be seen through naked eye. These organisms can be seen only with the help of the microscope. So they are also known as microbes. The study of microorganism is known as microbiology. Microorganism occurs everywhere. If we take microorganisms, nearly 5 organisms come under microorganisms. What are they? Virus, bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoan. Now we are going to start with virus. What is virus? Virus is a tiny particle made up of genetic material and protein. Virus is an intermediate between living and non-living things. What is the meaning of virus? The meaning of virus is poison in Latin. The study of virus is called virology. If we take the structure of the virus, virus consists of only 2 parts, that is a nuclear material, that is DNA or RNA, and surrounded by protein coat. So only 2 parts in structure of the virus. Virus consists of both living characters and non-living characters. The living characters of the virus are, they respond to heat, chemical and radiation. Virus reproduces. Virus shows irritability. These 3 characters are living characters of the virus. The non-living characters of the virus are, they are present freely in the environment, that is inactive. Freely in the environment. They can be crystallized and can be stored for a long time. Their cytoplasm is absent in virus. Virus causes many diseases in plants, animals and human beings. These are the non-living characters of the virus. And now we will start with bacteria. Bacteria is a single-celled prokaryotic. What is prokaryotic? Cells without nucleus. They are considered to be free living organism on earth. The study of bacteria is called bacteriology. If we take bacteria based on the respiration, 2 types of bacteria are there. Anaerobic bacteria and aerobic bacteria and anaerobic bacteria. Aerobic bacteria means it requires oxygen for its respiration. Anaerobic bacteria means it does not require oxygen for its respiration. If you take a structure of a bacterial cell, the outer covering of the bacterial cell is covered by cell wall, and the nuclear material is represented by nucleoid, that is without nuclear membrane. The nuclear material is not surrounded by nuclear membrane. Another important thing that present in a bacteria is plasmid, that is extra chromosomal DNA. And the many organelles are there in the cell. The organelle that is present in bacteria is, the only organelle present in the bacteria is ribosomes. The other cell organelles like mitochondria, Golgi body, endoplasmic reticulum are absent in bacteria. The locomotive organ of the bacteria is flagella. The different types of bacteria. If we take a bacteria according to their shape, they are classified into 4 types. What are they? Bacilli, rod-shaped bacteria. Spirilla, spiral-shaped bacteria. Cocci, spherical or round-shaped bacteria. Vibrio, comma-shaped bacteria. And the next type of classification is, bacteria is once again classified into according to the number and arrangement of flagella. Here, the bacteria is classified into 5 types. That is, monotrichus, that is with only single flagella. Lophotrichus, that is with a tougher flagella at one end. Amphitrichus, flagella at both the ends. Peritrichus, all over the body. Flagella all over the body. Atrichus means without any flagella. Bacteria is divided into two according to their mode of nutrition. Photosynthetic bacteria prepare their own food. Example, cyanobacteria. And some bacteria prepare their food with the help of chemicals. Example, ammonium hydrogen sulfide. They are called as chemosynthetic bacteria. Chemosynthetic. Another type is symbiotic relationship. Symbiotic relationship means mutual understanding. For example, E. coli is a bacteria that lives in the large intestine of man. Bacteria reproduces by fission, that is both binary and multiple fission. Next, now we are going to continue with fungi. Fungi is an eukaryotic organism, that is the organism with all the cell organelles. It lacks chlorophyll. No green pigment is present in fungi. Sometimes the fungi are unicellular and sometimes it may be in multicellular. For unicellular, yeast is an example, and for multicellular, Penicillium is example. The study of fungi is called mycology. Example for unicellular fungi is yeast. So now we are going to continue with yeast. Structure of the yeast. Structure is yeast is a unicellular fungi. It freely present in the atmosphere. Its shape is ovoid and contains cell wall and nucleus. Yeast helps in fermentation. For fermentation, it contains a special enzyme called zymase. Yeast reproduces by budding. And the example for a multicellular fungi is mushroom. You all know about mushroom, isn't it, girls? Mushroom grows on wet soil during the rainy season. This umbrella shaped structure that grow above the soil level is known as fruit body. It is also called as mycelium. And this stripe like parts, black stripe like part, that we call it as gills. Mycelium is turned into many thread like structures called hyphae. Mushroom reproduces by fragmentation and spore formation. Fungi, the nutrition, fungi are saprophytic. They derive nutrition from dead and decomposing animals and plants. Some fungi are parasitic. They depend living cells of the host. Some fungi are symbiotic, have a mutual relationship with other living organisms. For example, mycorrhizia. And the next microorganism that we are going to continue with is algae. Algae is a eukaryotic organism found in moist habitat. Algae are rich in chlorophyll and it is also called as grass of water. The study of algae is called phycology or allology. In algae also, unicellular and microscopic algae and multicellular macroscopic algae are there. For unicellular microscopic algae, Chlamydomonas is example, and for multicellular macroscopic example is Sargassum. If we start with the unicellular algae, example is Chlamydomonas. So Chlamydomonas is a unicellular algae and its shape is oval or spherical or pyriform. The cell wall cell is surrounded by a thin and firm cell wall called cellulose. This is the diagram of a Chlamydomonas. Please draw and try. The cell contains dark brown nucleus lying inside the cavity. The chloroplast shape of the chloroplast is cup shape. It has two flagellas and two contractile vacuoles and a tiny red colored eye spot. Chlamydomonas exhibits both sexual and asexual reproduction. And if we take algae consists of is classified into four types based on the presence of photosynthetic pigments: brown algae, yellow algae, red algae, blue algae, and sometimes blue green algae. And now at last we are going to continue with protozoa. Protozoa is a single celled eukaryote. Proto means first, zoa means animal. So protozoa means it's a first animal that exists on the land, on the water, sorry, marine. The study of protozoan is called protozoology. They only found in moist ocean ponds, ocean moist soil. Some examples of protozoan are: this is Plasmodium, this is Paramecium, and this is Euglena. And we are going to see an example for protozoan. The familiar example for protozoan is amoeba. You all know about amoeba, isn't it? Amoeba is a unicellular microscopic organism. It is found in ponds. It is irregular in shape and it moves from one place to another place with the help of a pseudopodia. Pseudopodia means false feet. And its body flows around the food particles and engulfs in forming a foot vacuoles. Contractile vacuoles are seen inside the cytoplasm, which helps in excretion. Amoeba reproduces by means of fission and sporulation. The structure of amoeba is very important. Please practice this diagram. We will continue this second part of the lesson in next video. Thank you, girls.